best friends, new strangers.
It's game time in Phoenix as the crowds at the U.S. Airways Center look to cheer on the Suns. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. We'll be seeing Kevin Garnett, and guys, really one of the great players to watch.
Well, the thing with Garnett, Kevin, is he's still one of the best players in the league. He doesn't finish quite as well around the basket.
.137 left in the first quarter. It's stolen. Now let's send it to Doris on the sideline.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, I caught up with Z for a bit. There has been some talk of late that there is some friction between he and his teammates over how much he calls for the ball. I asked him about it, and he said, if there is any, I hope it can be put to rest at some point. We're all on the same team trying to reach the same goals. We'll see if they can iron out their issues, guys.
And this isn't too big of a surprise if you've seen some of his quotes about his teammates.
Well, he certainly didn't endear himself to any of them. I mean, now you've got some serious chemistry issues on your hands.
Here's the screen. Outside Dragic lets the three fly, and he gets it to go. Dragic has got 7 points.
They've made one basket after another since getting this game started, and you wonder, is the blowout in store?
Too early to say that and go there, Steve, but it has been pretty ugly so far.
Thornton, that's in there. Johnson with the assist.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Suns leading by 9. Newman, the pass to Dragic. Dishes at the land. Pass to Fry. Here's the three. Good on the shot. Fry's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
An unusual skill set for a big man. The long-range shot gives you such good spacing offensively.
Here is Livingston. He's guarded by Newman. And there's a whistle. That goes on Z. That's his first foul. Livingston kicks over the watch. And there's the pass to Livingston. And here's Anderson for 3. Can't get it to go. And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And for the Suns, this has been the game they wanted to have.
And they set the tone there defensively with their shot blocking. They've been really intimidating down in the paint area.
You know, in the rest of the game, Steve, shooters will be looking around for the shot blockers because of what's happened in this quarter.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for the Suns, Newman, he's in at point guard. Markieff Morris is out there with Okafor. Then it's P.J. Tucker. Suns leading by 12.
Well, you know, Jeff Hornacek, the new coach of the Phoenix Suns, a 14-year career as an NBA shooting guard, and he was terrific as a player. Spent his first 6 in Phoenix and only recently really got into coaching, starting as an assistant with the Jazz in early 2011.
Here's Thornton. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Sacramento. Williams sets a screen for Thornton. Anderson dishes to Williams. That's out of bounds. Brooklyn will retain possession. And back to Coach Hornacek, the 16th. Here's Newman. He's covered by Livingston. From beyond the arc, no good from Newman. Last game for Brooklyn, they picked up the W against the Kings in Sacramento.
They looked very stable, pretty much from the get-go, guys. A solid output, solid effort. And, you know, sometimes you'll see some inconsistencies come up in the road game, but they were pretty solid there.
I was very impressed with the balance they displayed, guys. Different people carrying the load, scoring, making assists, unselfish play. Everything was working for them to get that victory.
Passes it to Dragic. Here's Newman. He had 13 points in the win against Portland. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Well, I think they've lost their aggressiveness a little bit. They're not getting fouled and going to the line.
Well, you know, that's an excellent point you make there, Steve, but we got to be careful not to nitpick here. I mean, they do still have the lead, and that's an advantage they'd be wise to continue to press forward on.
Both free throws good from Newman.
Yep, great focus at the free throw line. They're taking care of business.
That's exactly how you keep on the lead. 100% free throwing for the quarter. That'll do it.
That's tipped. 1 second left. He got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. And so that's the end of the first half. Suns lead by 9. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
I'm here with Joe Johnson. And, Joe, one of the challenges with having such a deep roster like yours is figuring out everyone's roles in the system. How is the new chemistry coming together with a mix of all-star talent?
We're just trying to feel one another out, man. You know, it's a long season. So, obviously, early in this young season, man, we're just taking our time right now, trying to feel our way through everything, and, you know, everything else takes care of itself.
There's no doubt it's a process, Joe. Thanks for the time. Guys?
Thanks, Doris. And, folks, the halftime show is coming up next. And then it's on to the third quarter. We'll step aside right now.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
This is 2K Sports, and I'm Damon Bruce, coming to you live on a Friday night. The Suns are off to a good start, a strong beginning to the season. They've wasted no time in getting off on the right foot. Offensively, they've been in a zone. A lot of great team play, providing looks from all over the floor. And still hanging in there, the Brooklyn Nets. They haven't settled on tough shots. They're taking it strong inside. They're getting quality shots and a lot of quantity of those quality shots. And that does it for us here in the studio. Thanks so much for joining me. And now, back out to Kevin and the gang.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Here's Newman. Inside. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break.
So for Brooklyn now,
Johnson is out there with Andre Kirilenko. Then it's Blatch. Then there's Deron Williams. And it's Thornton in at the two guard.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
You know, Deron Williams is so strong and so poised in the post. I'd like to see him down on the block a little bit more often. There are very few point guards in this league who really have the strength to deal with Williams in a post-up situation.
Thornton off a pick from Kirilenko. Fires it up. And that one comes up a bit short.
And you know why he was open there. They didn't commit too much defense to him, and you can see why. He has trouble making that shot.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Gentlemen, Alex Len was rumored to be the number one overall pick in the draft, but eventually ended up going fifth to the Phoenix Suns. Upon hearing where he was going, the Ukrainian was pleased about the situation. Not only was he walking into an opportunity to play, but he also loves the Phoenix weather, something that is quite different than the Ukraine. And who wouldn't love the Phoenix sky, guys?
They say his practice habits are top-notch. The sky's the limit for this guy. Thanks, Doris. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. Count it, and the foul. Pierce, and so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for the Suns.
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin. Closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
And guys, I think you've got to give them credit for the number of steals they've taken away. I mean, a lot of effort on the defense from them tonight.
Sean Livingston, he's checked in for the Nets. Here's Newman. Kicks it out to Barbosa. To Christmas. Tries it from 9. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
The Nets had a really solid debut season in Brooklyn last year. They made the big move in trading for Joe Johnson, but they also made some small adjustments that paid off for him as well.
And the Nets making a change here. Lopez is checked in. The feed to Thornton. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist. Williams has got three assists now in this one.
With the success they've been having from the three-point line since halftime, I'll bet you that scoreboard starts to look a lot different real soon.
Of course, they have to stay hot. But if they do, I think you're right, Clark, particularly if they can convert defense into offense.
He kicks it to Kirilenko. Thornton passes to Williams. Garnett left side. And it's Brooklyn scoring again.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
Here's Newman. With one on the clock. Got it off in time, but it's no good. And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively. And that's it for the third quarter. Both teams scoring well as we head to the fourth. And while we can now, let's take a look at today's State Farm assist of the game.
Well, tremendous point guard play, but that's nothing new coming from him. This is what you expect, a gorgeous feed there.
Okafor against Lopez. Okafor with a screen on Williams. Newman, the pass to Dragic. Here's Newman. Poked away. Newman, he's in at the point. Okafor out there with Markieff Morris. Then there's Dragic, and it's Green in at the three slot. That's who's out there for Phoenix. Phoenix has gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. Newman with the bucket.
Despite his interference, team has found other scoring options, which you have to have when one of your main guys is struggling.
On its way from Thornton for two, and it's good off the back of the rim and in.
And he's someone the defense has to keep track of at all times because, you know, even when he doesn't have the ball, he moves so well without it, he's constantly a threat to catch and shoot.
And also, he's absolutely able to do some incredible things in the air. I mean, he can look like a gymnast sometimes, twisting his body, double clutching his shot. But he maintains a smooth approach to it all.
Williams in the post, guarded by Newman, and it's blocked by Morris. Throws it up high, and Green slams it in.
That's the epitome of teamwork right there, Kevin, on the alley-oop.
Well, Clark, what about the finish? Bring her down with some thunder.
Yeah, lightning, too.
But I'll tell you, the pass was even better. I mean, he put it on an absolute platter for him.
Now the dish to Garnett. Thornton with it. Green with the rebound. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. Guys, this offense very effective.
Going right at him.
And this is where you just start picking apart the defense. And now you take their confidence away. You can really take control of this game.
And what a game for Green. He has 9 rebounds, and free throws have been big for him today, with 6 points from the line.
Well, you know, he understands the value of those easy points. Also, you know, getting the opponent into foul trouble. I mean, those are big. Those are the little things that will add up for a team trying to get a victory.
Andre Kirilenko is checked in for Marcus Thornton. Lopez right side. And again, no good by Brooklyn. Phoenix leading by 7. There's the lob to the hoop. And Green slams it in.
Really nice possession here. The focus has never wavered as this game has unfolded.
And with time running down here in the fourth, they may need to add only a few more points to their lead to put it away.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Thanks, Kevin. Jason Kidd had some words for his team over that last break. He was riding them pretty hard for the number of silly fouls they've committed in this game. He said, listen, we need to have some defensive discipline. Stop biting on the shot fakes, stop reaching in, and stop giving them free points at the free throw line. We'll see if they'll respond, guys.
Here's Newman, and it's good off the back rim and in.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
Kirilenko kicks to Williams. Fast break, here come the Suns. Here's Newman. He's guarded by Williams. Newman, the pass to Okafor. Johnson attacking. Makes good on the step back jumper.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Suns leading by six. We've got 1:13 left in the fourth quarter. Feeds to Morris. All sorts of time. Here's Okafor. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. And the Suns lead by eight.
Good rebound there, but overall, they're getting outworked on the glass.
Steve, I think that's what you'd expect, seeing what the score is.
It's in! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just five.
Not too many of those shots were dropping for him in the first half, but it's been a different story here in the second.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
The Nets have gotten more than 58% of their attempts to go down for them in the fourth quarter. They're 7 of 12. A shot by Williams, no good.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
And he gets it to go.
And a terrific run to really put this ball game away.
And now let's see how many more points they can throw up there before the horn sounds.
Johnson can't get it to go.
Even though he missed it, he couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, that's an easy jump shot. You got to take that.
Even from here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Yep, pretty obvious. And a good call by the official.
A good substitution here for Brooklyn. Andre Blatch, he's checked in for Lopez. Mirza Toledovich comes in for Kevin Garnett. Allen Anderson's checked in for Andre Kirilenko. And it's Livingston in for Joe Johnson.
And that ought to do it. I think any chance for a miracle comeback just went out the window with those free throws.
And again, no good by Brooklyn. Here's Newman. Gets the 14-footer to fall.
Terrific job taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And Steve, I thought those home fans gave this team a big lift all game. A lot of positive energy in the building.
And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one. You know, Clark, every team has a bad night. These guys might want to watch the tape of this game the next time they have a bad night to remind themselves how dominant they can be.
Well, this is one of those dreamlike games for a coach.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Yes, guys, I'm here with Goran Dragic. And, Goran, what a nice show the team put on for your fans tonight.
Yeah, great game for us, for our fans. They were amazing. This kind of games is really enjoying to play. We are hustling on every play, defense and offense. And, you know, I'm really happy that we won that game.
You enjoyed it, and we enjoyed it. Thank you, Goran. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. And, folks, that about concludes our broadcast tonight. For Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching as we leave you with our Jordan Player of the Game, Z.
Come on, come on.